And this is what the f orbital looks like. We know that for the value of f orbital is represented by L equal to 3, right? Correct? L equal to 0 is S, right? L is equal to 1 is P, L is equal to 2 P, L is equal to 2 is D, and L is equal to 3 is F, and the corresponding values of M are minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay? And so there are seven such possibilities. So here you see seven orbitals, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Apart from just looking at the shape and maybe understanding how it looks, apart from that, there's hardly any application of these shapes at this stage. At this point of time, right? But since we have done that and our electrons keep on going to the f orbitals, it is important that you just have a look at it. Okay, how they bond and what happens when they bond and how the electrons actually leap out and attach with and then kind of get shared with other orbitals. That will come to you in the next chapter. But it, to say the least, it is complicated, right? The nomenclature more so, fine. But we should know that there are seven of them, and maybe they have kind of six kind of balloons pointing in different directions, with these being the nodal planes, right? These are the nodal planes, right? This, okay. Wherever you see a gap, that's a nodal plane, fine. So that is how the orbitals normally look. Fine. That's how they look, and then we'll move on to the energies of the orbitals and how the electrons are distributed in these orbitals. That is called the electronic configuration. Fine. That we'll do in the next.